The Toronto Maple Leafs shot at the Edmonton Oilers again. Hello everyone, welcome back to the 23rd episode of Rate That Leafs Game, where I get you to give me the rating after the game. We put it all together and we create one average fans Leafs game rating. And today we are talking about the Edmonton Oilers versus the Toronto Maple Leafs. And what do the Leafs do? Well, like I just said, they shut out the Edmonton Oilers for the second straight game. Back-to-back shutouts for the Toronto Maple Leafs. First, it was Jack Campbell. Now, it's Michael Hutchinson. Also, after 12 o'clock last night, it was his birthday. So, what do I have to say? Happy birthday, Hutch. This is a straw, but it's got to do. Again, though, the Leafs win 3-0 in a performance over the Oilers that was phenomenal. Their best, I'd say, all-around game, so maybe one of the best. Their best, though, defensive game against the world's best player in Connor McDavid. They let him get behind the defense, I think, once or twice. But when that happened, Michael Hutchinson was there. He made every single save possible. 31 stops in this game, and he was one of the big backbones to this team getting the win last night. Before we go any deeper, though, I just want to talk about what I was doing last night. I wasn't really tweeting about the Leafs game because, actually, I was at the Toronto Marlies game where they won 3-2 in their first home game of the season at Coca-Cola Coliseum. What happened in that game? Well, Nick Robertson scored a nice goal off a beauty feed from Alex Galchenyuk. He got his first point on the Toronto Marlies. Robertson with his second goal of the season. And last but not least on it, Rich Kloon was named the 9th Marlies captain in franchise history. So, I mean, congrats to him. He's got a great story. It's one that really, really, really means something to this team. And if you haven't watched Hi, My Name is Dickie on Amazon, you have to watch it. It's one of the best documentaries I think I've ever seen in my life. It's raw, it's emotional, and it's one that just shows the life of Rich Kloon and just how he's grown as a person. And once again, though, I didn't say it last night in the Zoom call. I probably should have, but congrats, Rich. It's been nice covering you so far. You're really, 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 really nice. You seem like a great person. Every player and Greg Moore has said you're a great person. So, again, congrats on the captaincy. And I'm happy I get to cover you. And I just want to show the tweet. I'm not gloating. I'm very thankful to be in the position I'm at, even just to cover the Toronto Marlies. But let alone to go to a game. It was mind-blowing. It was so weird to watch maybe the first hockey game, and I think live in a calendar year. So without further ado, I said tonight I'm sit in my first ever office. Nice view of the game. You had to come into the arena. You had to get tested. Then you got to find your way to your seat, which I got to sit in the Marlies press box. And it was very tough trying to find that. I'll just say that. But I eventually found it. I was stressed. I was going nuts inside. And just to be there again was mind-blowing. And I'm so lucky. I want to say thanks to the Leafs Nation for letting me be one of the people who get to cover this team. But back to the game. More thoughts. Well, what do we have to think about? The Leafs win, again, their second straight game against the Edmonton Oilers without Austin Matthews. Who are the key contributors in this one? Well, William Nylander, obviously. Mitch Marner, obviously. A really good one that I'm happy to say was Morgan Rielly. This game for him was probably one of the best offensive games of the season so far. His best, I'd say, defensive game so far. The best defensive game by the whole team, shutting down McDavid and Draisaitl. They limited them to not many chances. I mean, McDavid had 6 shots in this game, so it had a lot to do with Michael Hutchinson making every save possible. But again, the Leafs limiting those high danger scoring chances for the Edmonton Oilers and just getting the win. It was nice getting a shutout, but again, getting the win without bodies. You're missing Austin Matthews, Frederick Anderson, Jack Campbell. You're missing Wayne Simmonds as well. And for them to get this win, for them to get both wins, it's a good testament on them to see how far they've come from last season. So what would happen in this game? Well, 7 minutes into the first period, Engvall brings a puck into the Oilers zone, get it to Mikheyev, who'd get it to Riley, who would make a beautiful pass. The eyes on this pass were amazing. This was a great feed through, I think, two Oilers players to get to Zach Hyman, who would go on his backhand, beat Mikko Koskinen, and it's 1-0 Oilers. I almost just said Oilers, but it's 1-0 Leafs. This line of Engvall, Mikheyev, and Hyman is, I think you really have to stick with this line going forward. It could be considered the checking line for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Engvall, with his size, his deceptive speediness, Sheldon Keefe even said, I think yesterday or the day before, that he has so much more to unlock. He doesn't even know his potential, and I agree. I mean, at some points, it looks like Engvall is really not into the game, and at other points, he just looks like he's this beast of a player who can be so much better, and I'm excited to see whether or not he can be like that. And Engvall is a good player, and at the end of the day as well, Mikheyev on that side, hardworking. He's like a dog, like Zach Hyman. He's always hardworking, doing the things he needs to do and doing them right. And again, Hyman as well, you can't say anything bad about him. He's there every single night, putting in every single shift, and I mean, overall, that line, I really want to stay as the third line going forward when all the injuries are healed and all the Leafs players return to the lineup. 3 minutes later, though, what happened? Well, the Leafs would score again. Again. Off the faceoff, just outside the Leafs zone, it would come up to William Nylander. He would be on a partial break. He would beat Mikko Koskinen on the backhand. 2-0 Leafs. I almost forgot about this stat, but I'm going to put it in now. The Leafs score on two straight shots against the Edmonton Oilers. Mikko Koskinen did not have good chances on these saves. He should have made them. He didn't. The Leafs capitalized, and they're up 2-0. Willie Styles is his new nickname. He has it on his sticks. He said after the game last night that it was from Joe Thornton when they were quarantining around Christmas time before the season started. Willie Styles has 4 goals in his past 3 games. He scores his 9th of the season, and the Leafs are just dominating against the Edmonton Oilers so far in this game. This play, though, overall by William Nylander, great individual play to just come up the ice using, I'd say he has maybe a bit of deceptive speed. He can turn on the jets when he needs to, and people, I don't think, notice how fast he can really get. And when he gets fast, like he did last night on that goal, he just beat a player and got his positioning and got the backhand off, and it beats Koskinen, and again, the Leafs are up. Question, though. Would the Edmonton Oilers get into this game in the first period? Well, no, not really. No. The Leafs would get a power play a minute 53 left in the first period. William Nylander with a nice play across to the other side of the ice to Mitch Marner to Morgan Rielly. And Morgan Rielly absolutely leans into this slap shot. And when I say he leans on it, he absolutely leans on it. He fires it past Mikko Koskinen. It would actually go off Darnell Nurse in front and then past Koskinen, and it's now 3-0 Toronto. Morgan Rielly's 3rd of the season. It's actually his first goal in almost a month's time. And again, the Leafs on the power play here without Austin Matthews find a way to capitalize. They're obviously going to. They're a good team, and even without Austin Matthews, they have a deadly power play in Mitch Marner, John Tavares, William Nylander, Joe Thornton, and Morgan Rielly is the first unit. So you'd think that they would do good, and they did on this one. Again, Nylander on this play with a great pass, I'd say through the seam, over to Mitch Marner, and he just gives it to Rielly, who absolutely blasts the bomb. And again, Leafs are up 3-0 in the first period. Now again, you know that the game is 3-0. That's how it would finish. But we got to talk about Michael Hutchinson and his a few big ones in this game that helped the Leafs just finally pull out the win in this one. At the start of the second, there was a shot by Adam Larsson, and it made its way to the net. He made the stop, but there was a big scramble in front, and he made a big save with his glove hand that did not allow the Oilers to put one past him. Then the start of the third, there's a giveaway behind the net. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins is there. He spins, he fires, and who's there? Michael Hutchinson. He makes another big, big save here. And then last but not least, there's a nice play where the puck comes up to Connor McDavid. This play, though, I want to talk about it for a second. He leaves the puck through. He lets it go by him, just comes in, gets it, and he would try to beat Hutchinson. He couldn't. On the breakaway. Connor McDavid on the breakaway could not solve Michael Hutchinson. What does that say about Hutchinson? Well, that says that he is a good goaltender. And at the end of it all, the Toronto Maple Leafs win and shut out the Edmonton Oilers and now move 8 points ahead of them in the NHL standings. Just again, quick on Michael Hutchinson. A great game overall again. 31 saves. 6 saves against Connor McDavid. 3 against Leon Draisaitl. So the Leafs defense here, I mean, they did really good against them both, not limiting them to the high danger scoring chances. Like I said before, the McDavid one was one where it was a big, big save by Hutchinson to keep the Leafs at bay and not with a goal against. So a big game for him, a big game for the Leafs defense here, shutting down this whole Oilers team once again. But again, this is a team and a look that you look back on in the game and you think, wow, we pulled out a win without our best player in Austin Matthews, Wayne Simmonds. We had Michael Hutchinson, who's not, I wouldn't say he's a third string goalie at this point, but he could be a backup on some teams. And he came in here when he's usually on the taxi squad, pulled out another win, another shutout for the Leafs. And it was a great game overall. No mistakes made here. It was just a strong one by the Leafs. Last thing though I'll say on the Leafs so far in these few months now. It's gone 2 months into the season. It's weird. It's weird seeing them up. It's weird seeing them so far ahead in the standings. Again, they're 8 points ahead of the Oilers. They're 6 points ahead of Florida for first place in the NHL. I mean, I don't know how to react. I don't know whether this is a dream, whether this is reality, whether I'm going to get my heart broken. That's not going to happen because the Leafs are a different team this year. And we know that. And I mean, we just got to keep going up from here. Don't let injuries bug this team. Don't let it bug you, because you know at the end of the day that the Leafs are a good defensive team, a good offensive team, and one that has 3 good goaltenders right now. And we're lucky to have each and every player. Now though, we gotta go to the rating of this game. And this one is our highest rating so far. I don't even know what to say about it. I mean, yeah, sure, let it go this high. But again, I mean, it's out of 10. And this is way past 10. Everyone that rated this game, they put it over 10. There were a few that were maybe okay, like 11 out of 10, 9 out of 10, and stuff like that. But the rating of this game, I'm just going to give it to you right now. The rating of this game is a 24.5 out of 10. Plus, you had Totally Offside giving 3 Michelin stars to the Toronto Maple Leafs. William Nylander's a chef, Morgan Riley's a chef, and Zach Hyman is one too. And those 3 chefs make up the best restaurants in the NHL, which is the Toronto Maple Leafs. Again, the last thing I'm going to say on this team is that they're good. They are really good. And people are starting to acknowledge it. You also have the people who are like, oh, the league is just bad. The league is just so bad that the Leafs are just doing good. No, like no. Like, no! Austin Matthews, after missing 3 games this season, still has 18 goals and is still in first place. Second is Connor McDavid with 14. Mitch Marner is also in fourth place in the league in terms of points with 33. So, I mean, are the Leafs bad? No. Are the Leafs facing bad teams? You could say that some teams are struggling, but again, we just shut out Connor McDavid twice. So, I mean, no, they're not a bad team at all. And it just makes me more excited to see them face other teams and see how they can do. But we won't have to see that until the conference finals. And with the way it's going right now, it really looks like the Leafs are going to make it there. So until you see them face other teams, I would like you to please stop talking about the Toronto Maple Leafs and how they're facing bad teams, because they are very very good. Now though, after yelling at the people who say that the Leafs are a bad team and they're facing bad teams, that is where I'm going to end off the video. I want to thank you so much for watching. If you do enjoy the video, please make sure to leave a like. Please subscribe. It really helps a lot. I mean it. I really mean it. And please, put a comment down below. I like interacting with everyone. So if you see this and you've made it to the end of the video, put a comment down below, maybe saying happy birthday Michael Hutchinson or something like that, just so I know you've made it to the end of the video. But that is going to be it. So again, thank you so much for watching. Go Leafs go! I forgot to mention I got to witness Martin Marincin live in the flesh last night. I should have brought my jersey, but that would have been unprofessional. Do not do that. But again, he was good. So was Galchenyuk. So was Robertson. So was the entire Marlies team last night. And again, thanks to the Leafs Nation for letting me cover this team. And I mean, I'm the luckiest. I'm very lucky. But yeah, that is it. Thank you so much again for watching. We'll see you in the next video.